some interesting things you've already heard today several times, but we try to go and look at it a bit more into detail, and that is the opportunities and constraints of conservation strategies, of biodiversity conservation strategies, like protected areas, on safeguarding ecosystem services and therefore providing an improved environment for people. We do this with a whole bunch of people. We're all seated, like we have the first row on the table. And when you all got in, you got a little small questionnaire. We put there like some five questions that we actually want you to take a look at right now and fill out the percentage of agreement. That if you look at those statements, they're quite challenging. But how much you agree or disagree with those propositions. If you just pass them on all to the right, so the three persons that will be sitting there, they will have questionnaires. Marta? Oh, and we will put them up for the discussion. So you will have a bit of light to steer the discussion at the end. I think I will stop. Now we plan to have the session for about 2 hours. We might be able to stop or 2 hours. That means Vanya, she will introduce the session. Explain you a bit more what we will be talking about. Well, Vanya, who's yours?
Good evening, for me. Just briefly introduce. We're going to talk about the services and livelihoods and constraints of protected areas. So, as you heard this morning, the Millennium Ecosystem Assessment has a tendency to include the ecosystem services into policy implementation. So this has been the biodiversity conservation strategies at European and global level. Given that the 2010 target has been achieved, the new target, the 2010 put on a new thing that has been incorporation of ecosystem services concepts. The way to do this is by expansion of protected areas and by creation of new protected areas, as well as other conservation strategies. As it has already been mentioned before, there have been many conservation strategies for conservation. We will mainly focus on three conservation strategies. The first we're going to talk about is the designation of protected areas. Already existing. This graph, this is a typical graph of the area of protected areas that we can see that the last year is increasing. A typical strategy of protected area expansion in South Africa where they by 2012 the protected areas by 3,000. Kilometers and by 120,000 kilometers. So, apart from the protected area conservation, the PES schemes as well as the Red Plus strategies have been detailed this morning. And we're not going to describe them now because we just want to talk about the main issue. Strategies is that a more human in nature view in their strategy. They want to include the local society in the conservation process. So our ongoing research a number of assessing the congruence between ecosystem services and biodiversity strategies Bulgaria. So what we have observed so far is that only maybe relatively it's not that small, is 14% of the studies that have been assessing the diversity. And what is not impressive is that most of them are the main question is that strategies like protected areas really work and really take consideration of we have a typical example here where area in Ghana and the land cover changes in the designation of the protected area in 2009. And what can be seen in the image is the land cover really change inside the boundaries of protected areas. However, in the two lower images, what has really changed is protected areas, the land use around them. So what we're going to really address is the potential benefits and conflicts that might livelihoods. So we have three presentations, and the first presentation will talk about how the protected areas are selected in order to meet the conservation goals, including ecosystem services in these areas. We have a second presentation, how land management could create trade-offs among ecosystem service beneficiaries. The final presentation will be about the limits to test threat classification. In the end, an interactive discussion.